हेलो फ्रेंड्स, नमस्ते। एवरीवन विल बी फाइन एंड यस, इट इज रिक्वायर्ड ड्यू टू द COVID-19। वी कुड नॉट स्टडी प्रॉपरली इन द क्लासरूम। इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट वी हैव यूज्ड द अनदर वेज टू लर्न। द टॉपिक टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज इनफ हेल्पफुल टू रीच आउट द सीक्रेट्स ऑफ लाइफ। It is also helpful to solve the several problems and BCGs regard with that several criminals. Criminal cases can be solved by the study of structure of DNA. Myself, Armad Gadvi, belongs to Sri Sarvajanik Science College, and I am availing the several information and the knowledge regarding the DNA. Generally, this DNA is formed of the two different strands. One is over here and the second one is over here. Okay, so these are the strands of DNA, and these both strands are joined together. Okay, and this joining of two strands is required for the stability of DNA. In the ancient time of biology, as everyone knows that we are the formation of God, as per the evolution, 3.5 billion years have been passed, and after the successful evolution we are formed. So we have to remember that in the same case, in ancient era, RNA was as the genetic material, and in that era only one strand was there, so our genetic material was just like this shape. So this RNA have not the another strand, and due to that reason this RNA get changed as it haven't the stability. So DNA helping us to be stable, and due to that reason the much mutation and changes are not observed. The structure of this DNA can be compared, this double helix structure of this DNA can be compared with the rotating staircase. Okay, here the every stair can be imagined as the pairing of two nucleotides. These two nucleotides, one will be over here, second will be over here, one will be over here, second will be over here, will be joined together by the hydrogen bond. Here the discovery is shown over here. Whatever the model of DNA, double helix DNA, was proposed by the Watson and Crick is shown over here in the 1952. Watson and Crick have given this double helix structure of DNA based upon this photograph. This photograph is taken by the student of Rosalind Franklin, and this photo is known as the photo 51 because it was the 51st number of photograph. It is known as the 51st photograph of X-ray crystallography, and this research was carried out by the Rosalind Franklin, and one of the student of Rosalind Franklin have captured this photograph. This photograph is showing us the structure of DNA. It is revealing the information about the structure, how would be the DNA. It is giving us the information. This information is shown as the proper formation. This both photograph have the only and only modernization chain. So we can see over here, here is the all base pairs only. So nitrogen base will be over here, and in this photograph, in this portion, sugar and phosphorus are there. Okay, so by understanding this photograph only, Watson and Crick have proposed the double helical structure of the DNA. So we have to remember him. The Rosalind Franklin should be wished on the 25th July, as she was born on that day. Francis Crick should be with on 8th June, as he was born on the day. And James Watson is also alive today also. We should proud on that thing. He was born on the 6th April. So, stairs of the DNA are there. The stairs of the DNA are made up of the nitrogen base. There are four type of the nitrogen base are there: adenine, thymine, guanine, and the cytosine. So these are the one, this is second, this is over here, second will be over there. So these are the base pairs. And whatever shown over here in the blue color is made up of the phosphorus and the ribose sugar. So it is made up of the phosphorus and the ribose sugar. So we can conclude that this DNA is made up of the ATGC. So in the structure of the DNA, there will be the sequence of the adenine, thymine, guanine, and the cytosine. So DNA also have the direction. So just suppose adenine is over here, thymine is over here. So it also have the direction, just suppose the 5 prime and the 3 prime. Okay. So if upper portion is there, then it will be known as the 5 prime. And if lower portion is there, then it will be known as the 3 prime. So 5 prime and 3 prime can be also understood over here. Just suppose this phosphorus is on the upper side. Here the carbon number 1 is here, second number is over here of ribose sugar, third number carbon is over here, and fourth number is over here, and fifth number carbon is over here. And this is the reason why this end is known as the 5 prime. And this sugar also have the first number of carbon, second number of carbon over here, third number of carbon over here, fourth number of carbon over here, and fifth number of carbon will be over here. And as this end have the 3 number of carbon, so this end will be known as the 3 prime. This structure of DNA can be compared with the ladders. Okay. So everywhere one step will be ahead. Just suppose over here the only and only one base pair, second will be over here, third will be over here. So this entire structure is made up of the only and only ladders and bases. In the structure, just suppose one base is over here, thymine is attached with the sugar and the phosphorus, and this one is known as the nucleotide. So DNA is made up of the sequence of oligonucleotides. Two antiparallel strands of oligonucleotides are joined and DNA is formed. So in this slide, we will learn how this nucleotide is making the DNA. In the nucleotide, three parts are there. One, that is the pentose sugar. This pentose sugar is ribose. Ribose sugar is over here. So this ribose sugar have the 5 carbon. As first number of carbon is here, second is over here, third is over here, fourth is here, and fifth number of carbon is here. So fifth number of carbon of ribose sugar is joined with the phosphorus. Okay, it is known as the phosphoric acid. So it is joined to the phosphoric acid, and first number of carbon is attached with the nitrogenous base. There are four different type of the nitrogenous base are there in the DNA: adenine, thymine, cytosine, and the guanine. Now the same structure is over here also. 1, 2, 3, 4 and the 5 number of carbon are there. Okay, so it is the structure of one nucleotide. As the full form of DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. As the full form of the DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid. So ribo is stand for the ribose sugar. Deoxy stand for the removal of hydroxyl group from the second number of carbon. So hydrogen will not be there in the structure. Deoxy, so hydroxyl group will not be over here, so it is known as the deoxy ribo because ribose sugar is there. Nucleic acid, because DNA is found in nucleus, so it is known as the nucleic acid. The word nuclein was given by the Friedrich Miescher, as he have discovered the nucleic acid, mean the some acid of phosphorus and the protein are found in the nucleus. He have analyzed the leukocytes and he have given the name nuclein, that some acids are found in the nucleus of cell of leukocytes, so it is known as the nucleic acid. So there are four type of the base are there: adenine, thymine, cytosine and the guanine. So I am giving you the entire story of these bases. There are two type of base are there: purines and the pyrimidines. Just suppose two base pair, thymine and this cytosine, are pyrimidines, and adenine and the guanine are the purines. So purine have the two heterocyclic rings and pyrimidines have the only one heterocyclic rings. So number of the carbon are also important. What you have to do if you want to draw this structure: first make the one ring of the benzene, and then after attach again the only five carbons over here. So in this case the number of carbon will be started from the over here 1 2 3 4 5 6 and 7 8 9. In this case 1 3 7 and 9, on the 1 3 7 9 there will be nitrogen. Okay, so it's all, and this ninth number of carbon is attached with the ribose sugar. Okay, so it have the hydrogen over here. Okay. In the same case pyrimidine also have the six carbon, one ring is there, and in this case the carbon number of carbon have started from the here 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. In the same case 1 and 3 have the nitrogen. Okay, and over here the first number of carbon will be joined with the ribose sugar. Here is the structure of the adenine. The number of the carbons will be started from the over here 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. Again 7 8 9 will be over here. Okay, so ninth number of carbon will be attached with the ribose sugar. Okay, here will be the phosphorus PO4. Here will be again 3' OH. Guanine also have the same structure, only guanine have the additional hydrogen and the oxygen over here. Okay. Additional amino group and the oxygen will be there. So it can be categorized, adenine will be said as the 6-aminopurine. It will be said as the 6-aminopurine, as the on the 6th number of the carbon there will be amino group. So adenine will be said as the 6-aminopurine, as this guanine will be known as the 6-oxy-2-aminopurine, because on the second number of the carbon 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, so on the second number of the carbon there will be the NH2, so it is known as the 2-amino-6-oxypurine. In the pyrimidine again have the one ring I am drawing over here. In this ring, if we want to give the names to the structures, just suppose here is the thymine, here is the uracil, and here is the cytosine. So first I am giving the name to cytosine. The number of the carbon again important, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. If I am giving the name to the cytosine, 2-oxy-4-aminopyrimidine is known as the cytosine. Another one, uracil, is there. So 2-4-dioxypyrimidine will be known as the uracil, and 2-4-dioxy-5-methylpyrimidine will be known as the thymine. So these all are the structures of nitrogenous base. This nitrogenous base, all this nitrogenous base will be attached to this first number of carbon of ribose sugar. Just suppose over here this first number of carbon will be attached over here, here also this first number of carbon will be attached over here, and here also this first number of carbon will be attached on the first number of the ribose sugar. In this figure, this can be properly understood. Just suppose first number of carbon is over here, first, second, third, fourth, and fifth. Just suppose over here is the thymine. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 are there. So first number of the carbon of the thymine and first number of carbon of the ribose sugar, both are joined together. And why we can say that this is the thymine? Because it have the 2-4-oxy, it have the 2-4-oxy and 5-methyl. So over here CH3 group will be there. So it is known as the 2-4-dioxy-5-methyl. Over here is the cytosine. So again, cytosine have the same thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 number of carbon are there. So one strand will be in the right direction, just suppose 5' to 3', okay, and the second will be anti-parallel, as it is the in the opposite direction. 5' will be at lower side and the 3' will be at the upper side. So the number of the third carbon will be on opposite side, upper side. Again, the number of the carbons, first number will be here, second will be here, third, fourth, fifth, and the sixth number. So 2-oxy-4-aminopyrimidine is known as the cytosine. So I think it will be clear, you can get properly. Again, now we are going for the purines. Just suppose adenine is there. So the number of carbon is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. In this case, it is the 9th number of carbon. Okay, so 9, 8, 7. This will be the 6th, 5th, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So 9th number of the carbon of adenine and the guanine. Guanine have the 9th number of carbon over here. 9, 8, 7, this is the 6th, 5, 4, 3, 2, and the 1. So 9th number of the carbon is attached with the first number of carbon of ribose sugar. And now the base pairing is also important. Just suppose thymine and adenine are joined together, then which number of the carbons will be there? Just suppose 4th number of the thymine and 6th number of the adenine will join. 4th number of thymine and 6th number of adenine will join. Okay. In the same way, 4th number of the cytosine and the 6th number of the guanine will be joined. Again, in the case of the cytosine. Third number of the carbon of cytosine mean the pyrimidine, and the first number of the carbon of purine mean guanine will be joined. In the same way, the third number of the carbon of the thymine mean the pyrimidine, and the first number of the adenine will be joined over here. And the remaining second number of this carbon in the case of the thymine and adenine will not be joined, but in the case of the guanine and cytosine, it will make the three hydrogen bonds. So the second number of the carbons will be joined over here. So I hope this bondings will be clear. Now some questions again will be there. Mean these are the hydrogen bonds between the thymine and the adenine. These have the double bond, okay, and it have the guanine and the cytosine have the triple bonds are there. Now one thing still we have to clear, and it is that which bonds are there. This is the hydrogen bond. Over here will be the glycosidic bond, beta glycosidic bond. Okay, and this two base will be joined by the hydrogen bond. Sugar and base, sugar over here is sugar, and base will be joined together by the glycosidic bond. And two, sugar will be joined by the phosphodiester bond. There will be two ester bond. One, if you have studied the ester bond, carbon, oxygen, and oxygen, then this type of bond is known as the ester bond. On the two side, if oxygen is there, so in this case again I am resuming the video, and in this part I am going to tell you the bonds, which type of bonds and where these bonds are present. So just suppose these two bases are there, nitrogen base are there. Just suppose one is the thymine over here and adenine is over here. So this both base will be joined together with the help of the hydrogen bond. This one nitrogen base, just suppose over here the nitrogen base and over here the sugar. So this will be joined together by the beta glycosidic bond. Beta glycosidic bond, we have to remember this also, beta glycosidic bond. And this two sugar, one is over here and second one is over here, this both will be joined together by the two ester bond. If one oxygen is there and this oxygen is joining the two carbon molecules, so these two carbon molecules are joined together with the help of the oxygen, so this type of bond will be known as the ester bond. So it is known as the ester bond. Okay, so in the case of the DNA, this two sugar, one is over here, second is over here, so this both will be joined together by the two ester bond, and these two ester bonds also joined together by the phosphorus. So this is known as the phosphodiester bond, because one is over here oxygen and it is joined together phosphorus and carbon of fifth number, and over here it is again joining the phosphorus and the third number of carbon. Okay, so third number of carbon is joined together with the help of the oxygen with phosphorus, and again this oxygen will join this carbon of five number. Okay, so these are the bondings. Three type of bonds are present in the DNA. The name of the purine and pyrimidines are shown in this slide, so you can pause this video and you can write if you want to remember it. Adenine will be known as the 6-aminopurine, guanine will be known as the 6-oxy, and 2-aminopurine. It is enough easy to remember. Thymine can be say at the 4-diol-pyrimidine, and 5 will be methine. Uracil will be known as the 2,4-diol oxypyrimidine, cytosine will be known as the 2-4-2-oxy and 4-aminopyrimidine. So how can we remember? We can remember just like the uracil will be 2-4-dioxypyrimidine, and in the case of the thymine, only 5 methyl group is additional. So on the number of 5th carbon, methyl group will be there. So it is enough easy to remember. To video animations are so we are going to watch this also. Hello friends, in this video animation we will study the structure of the DNA, how exactly this DNA look alike. Okay, so there will be the two major and the minor groups. One will be over here major and second will be minor. Over here the major group will be there and minor group will be there. This double-stranded DNA is shown in this video. It is unwinded. So the exactly real gauge is shown. So every units will be known as the nucleotides. One nucleotide have the 3 components. One is sugar, second is phosphorus, and third one is the nitrogenous base. There are 3 type of the nitrogenous base, 4 type of: adenine, guanine, thymine, and cytosine. It is known as the deoxy because on the second number of the carbon there isn't the hydroxyl group. Two sugars are bounded with the help of the phosphorus, and this phosphorus has joined together with the help of the oxygen, so it is known as the phosphodiester bond. Again, the one thing that is important in the structure is that always the guanine will be joined together with the cytosine. Mean two ring containing structure will be joined with the one ring containing structure, and two ring containing structure will be joined with the one ring containing structure. So just suppose this thymine will be always paired with the adenine, and guanine always will be paired together with the cytosine. So always the width of DNA will be same whatever the base are there. So DNA is shown in the helix form. So in this structure, the base pairs are shown. So here the first base pair is there, second is there, third is there, fourth is there. Okay. So in the one form, if one bond is there, then 10 base pair will be there. Okay. There also will be the pi-pi interactions between the two bases. So the structure will be also more stable compared with the RNA. There will be the major and the minor grooves, and this major and minor groove will help for the winding. During the winding, histone proteins will be joined with the DNA and the size will be occupied lower. We have the another animation. It will show the DNA wrapping, mean the how this DNA is arranged in the cell as it have the much and much size. The length of the DNA in the human cell is the 3 billion base pairs, so it will be the so much. So how this is the place in the one cell and the nucleus. So there are the histone proteins, and these histone proteins will come together and this DNA is winding upon it. This is the how the chromosome will be formed. So we can say that this chromosome is made up of the exactly DNA and the histone protein. This is the reason why the Friedrich Miescher found the protein in the nucleus. This protein was the histone and the histone 1 protein, and it helped in the winding. Again, these windings are in the helical shapes, and as a final, this chromosome will be formed. In this animation, this one cell is there and it is getting divided. During the division, this chromosomes and the genetic material will be come on the one plate. So here the one plate is shown, and this one plate is known as the metaphase plate, and then after this genome is get dividing. In the second number of the animation, this replication is shown, mean how this DNA is get replicated. During the replication process, whenever the cell division is there, then another copy of the DNA is required. If this DNA is not replicated, then the one cell will lack the copy of the DNA, but every cell will require the constitution of the life. So DNA is required, so replication is also required. So in this animation, this replication is shown, this how this DNA is get Xerox. In the 1 second, 200,000 base pairs are copied. Mean it is the much speedy process, but the accuracy is also surprising. So again, thank you.